Hi guys, I'm Kim and today I'm bringing you a wrap-up for the month of April. So everything I read in the month of April. But first let's do a little recap. I read 10 books in all in the month of April, two of which I already started in March. So out of those 8 books, only one was on my TBR and the other 9 I just read and they weren't on my TBR. All in all, I did start 4 books that I did not finish, but I didn't DNF them. I'm still planning on finishing them. 2 of those books were on my TBR and 2 weren't. So all in all, out of the 7 books that I had on my TBR, I read 1 and started 2, and the other 4 I just didn't read. And that's it. Out of the 10 books I read, all of them were over 300 pages and 9 of them I read or listened to in English and 1 I read in German. As for formats, I read 2 paperback books, 2 audiobooks or I listened to 2 audiobooks, 1 hardcover book and 5 books I read on my Kindle. And that's it for my stats. Let's get into the actual. Let's start with audiobooks. So all of the books, they aren't in any particular order. They're not in the order I rated them in or in the order I read them in, just in the order it is now convenient for me to show you. So the first one, as said, audiobook is The Name of the Wind by Patrick Rothfuss, the first book in the Kingkiller Chronicles. And I rated this book 5 stars. I absolutely loved it. It's just amazing. It's this epic fantasy story. I don't really know what to say about it. I'm actually currently listening to the second book in the series and I can't wait to like finish it because I just want to know what happens, although the third book isn't yet out, so I don't want to finish it because I don't want to wait for the third book. But yeah, it's hard to explain what this is about because, to be honest, I don't really see a plot as of yet. Like, it's about this guy Quoth who tells his life story to a scribe, and most of the book is just his life story. There's a little outside of it in the like present time with Quoth telling his story, but the main part of the book is his story. And in the first book we follow him from when he's really young until he's about, I'd say, between 15 and 17. I'm not exactly sure about his age. And we just follow him along and it's really interesting. A lot happens. It's really interesting. And he goes to university where he studies a lot of things, some things that are like magic to us, or there's, for example, alchemy and other things that we don't know about. So yeah, it's really interesting and he gets into a lot of trouble, so there's always something happening and it's really, really interesting. And that's it pretty much about the book. The first book I actually listened to before I listened to The Name of the Wind was Library of Souls by Ransom Riggs, the first book in the Miss Peregrine series, and I rated this book 3 stars. I didn't really like it, but I already knew that going in, so I just, in general, did not really like the series, but I wanted to finish it, so I listened to the book. There isn't anything really wrong with the book. It's not like with other books where I can say, okay, I did not like this and I did not like this, therefore I rated it like 3 stars or even 2 stars. It's just, I did not like the book. And that's it. I know a lot of people like the book and that's, I can understand why, but I don't like it. Yeah. So let's get into other books I actually read. The first book I read is the Fairy Loot book of the month of March. It's Empress of a Thousand Skies by Rhoda Bellessa. It's a young adult sci-fi novel and it's about this princess. Her parents have been killed when she was really young, and now she's getting older and she's supposed to ascend to the throne, but there's an attack on her life and she decides to pretend to be death, so to fake her own death to find out who tried to kill her and who killed her family. And it's really, really interesting. I rated it 4 stars. I really enjoyed it and I can't wait for the second book in the series. The next book I have is actually the only book I read in German. It's Der Weg des Inquisitors by Frank Rehfeld. It's a German book that hasn't been translated into English yet, so I don't have a title for you. It's kind of a historical fantasy and it takes place during the Middle Ages, or it doesn't. It's not a historical fantasy, it's actually high fantasy, But the world it takes place in is so reminiscent of the Middle Ages in Europe that I for myself consider it a historical fantasy, and I would not recommend any people who do not like historic fiction to read this, because it just reads so much like historic fiction with some fantasy elements, as the witches or the evil in this book, the evil the Inquisitors like hunt, is actually real. So kind of a historical fantasy for me. I rated it 3 stars because the first half of the book just didn't resonate with me. It was so boring. I just couldn't get into it. Nothing happened, I felt like, and I just didn't like it. But then about halfway through the book, things got really interesting, and I can't wait to read the second part or the second novel in the series. It's not out yet, so I have to wait, but I'm really excited for it, and I really, really like the book in the end. Then we have Given to the Sea by Mindy McGuinness. I actually read this book on my Kindle as well, because I got it off of NetGalley at the beginning of the month, or I got it earlier and I didn't get it off NetGalley. I got it off First to Read, I'm sorry. And I read it and reviewed it, and then just 2 weeks ago when the Fairy Loot box arrived, this was the book, so I decided to show you the actual book. I rated it 3 stars, I didn't really like it that much. Again, it's a high fantasy novel. It's about this girl who is supposed to be offered to the sea to stop the sea from invading the land and protect all the other people, but things don't go as planned. And yeah, that's pretty much it. That's the only thing I have to say about this book. Oh, and I have reviews for all of the books I read up on my blog and on Goodreads, and I'll link all of them below. So if you want to know more about the books or know more about my opinion of the books, you can just check that out. Then the last physical book I read was And I Darkened by Kirsten White, and I really liked it. I rated it 4 stars, which is a pretty high rating for the book, because the first half of the book I didn't really like. I only started liking it in the second part of the book, but then I liked it very much, and I just decided to rate it 4 stars for the latter half of the book. It's a historical fiction. It does kind of seem like a fantasy, but it isn't. It's a historical fiction taking place in Europe, or mainly in Europe. It takes place partly in Wallachia, which is Eastern Europe now, and partly in the Ottoman Empire, which is mainly Turkey now. And it's about this girl, Lara, who is the daughter of the prince of Wallachia, and she's sent to the court of the Sultan of the Ottoman Empire as collateral along with her brother. And we just follow her life and her brother's life, partly back in Wallachia and partly at a court. And Lara isn't really accepting of her role as a woman in these days, and she's a warrior, but she's a woman, and she is like a high-ranking woman, so she isn't really supposed to fight, even if she was a man. But she isn't a man, she's a woman, so yeah. Things happen. It's really interesting. Then right after having read I read Now I Rise, which is the second part in the series. I got this one off of NetGalley, and that's actually the reason I read both of those books. I did own And I Darken, and it was on my TBR, but the reason I read it in April was because I got approved for Now I Rise, and I just read both of them. I rated Now I Rise 4 stars as well. I'm not going to talk about it at all, because it's the second part of the series. And the next two books are also the first and second part in the series, and they are Truthwitch by Susan Dennard and Windwitch, which obviously is also by Susan Dennard, as they are the first and second part in the series. And let me tell you, I adored the books. Like, I rated both of them 5 stars. They're just so amazing, I can't even put it into words. Like, I think they're going to be some of my all-time favorite books. I just absolutely love them. The first book is about Safi and Isolde, two young girls who already get up to a lot of mischief, and a book simply about their regular regular life would be already pretty interesting, because just their relationship, their friendship, it is so interesting because it is so strong, it runs so deep. They trust each other like unconditionally. It's an amazing friendship, and both of them are really strong young women, and I think just following them in their everyday life would be really interesting, because as I said, they get up to a lot of mischief, but things happen, they have to flee, they have to run away, and it's just, it's so interesting, it's so fast paced, a lot of things happen. We follow them throughout the whole continent, they have to run away, they get separated, it's just so much happens and it's so interesting. And we also get to know a lot of other characters, characters that take a more important role in the second book. And I love it. I love both of those books. And I also love that kind of, while Safi and Isolde are the main characters in the first book, they are still very important in the second book. But they, like, other characters get more, like, screen time. Although I still think Isolde is one of the main characters in the second book, Safi is still very important as well, and her, like, following her is still very interesting. But also, as I said, other characters get more of time on the page. And I think, like, so there are four books, or there are supposed to be four books, and I think I already know which, the first book is Truth Witch, which is Safi. The second book is Wind Witch, which is Merrick. And then I think of the other four books, there will be one for Isolde, obviously, and then there will be one for Edwin, who is a Blood Witch. And yeah, I'm so excited to see more of all of them, and yeah, I don't know what to say, I just absolutely love the books. Then the last book I have is, The Witches of the Glass Castle by Gabriella Lepore. I actually got this book from Off Tom's Publishing. They are republishing this book and the second book in the series. They were re-released in April, and I was part of the blog tour to promote the re-release of this book. It's a contemporary fantasy novel. I rated it 3 stars. I didn't really like it that much. It's about those two siblings, like a brother and a sister, and they get told by their mother and their aunt, like, hey, you're witches, and instead of spending your summer break the way you would usually with your friends and doing whatever, you are supposed to go to this old castle and meet this old lady, and she's just showing you and a bunch of other kids how to use your magical powers. Cool, right? Yeah. They aren't happy, and then a lot of bad things happen, and just, it goes from there. I didn't really like it that much. It was just, I'm a lot more picky with contemporary fantasy than I am with high fantasy, I think. I just didn't really like the characters, and I didn't really enjoy the plot that much, so it wasn't really for me. But still, thank you to Off Toms for giving me the copy, the e-copy and whatnot, and letting me part of this blog tour, and yeah, that's all the books I read in the month of April. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe. And just let me know in the comments what you thought about those books, if you've read them, if you plan on reading them, or what you read in the month of April. And yeah, that's it. Bye!